Let's insert another slide. Add a shape. Add some text. Now we want to change this shape to set to circle slant. And this works similar to our set to circle perspective. Set to circle perspective is almost the top view of a cylinder, whereas our set to circle slant is more of a front view. I want to convert this to a curve. I see my little circle with the lines above it. And raising up my corners, this now kind of looks like a label on a can of soup from the front. And adding another shape. Selecting it. Going up to Distort. Yes, I want to convert that to a curve. And this does the same thing, but instead of wrapping around a circle as a front view or top view, just allows me to move my edges in a little bit. And these are all straight lines, not curved at all. I'm going to add another slide. On this slide, I'm going to create a clip art using the tools in the Effects Mode toolbar. Inserting a shape, I'm going to set and circle slant. Now I'm going up and using my rotate tool, holding down shift so it locks me in. And I want to make that 90 degrees. Now, just as an ordinary object, I'm shrinking it down a little. I'm going to use my distort to bring in the ends a little bit here. And now it's starting to look like a sail, which this is going to be a sailboat. So I need to insert a mast for my sailboat. Change the color of this to black. Let's move it over a bit and send it to the back. I need to create the boat itself. I'm going to do that with my polygon. And that looks pretty good, but we still have two tools we haven't used here, our transparency and our gradient. Let's click on our sail and look at the transparency. The first thing we notice is the transparent is down here at the white square with the arrow going towards the white. And on the other end of the line, we've got a black square, which means the opaque part. Clicking and dragging my transparent square moves it around like a clock. Clicking and dragging the opaque allows me to set the range of the transparency. As I get closer, less and less is transparent. With the opaque square in close, now if I move my transparent square, we still can only go around the border of our picture. And increasing the transparency, let's move this up to the corner. We can also control this transparency by clicking on our area transparency. So that's our transparency. To make our gradient control work, we need to click on our area control again and go into gradients. So gradient 1 is the default, and that one did not turn on our gradient button. So let's pick another one. Maybe linear yellow and brown. And I'm just going to leave all the defaults and click OK. The first thing we notice is the gradient is not selected. To activate the gradient, I need to click on this. And here we see the same thing. We've got a light colored box and a dark colored box with the arrow going towards the one box. Moving that one moves it like a clock. Moving the other box in and out for the amount of that color of the gradient. I'm going to move our dark color on the opposite side of our transparency. Move this in just a little more. So it looks like it's dark, getting lighter, lighter, and transparent as it's getting lighter. And I want to go back to my transparent. And I like this pretty good, but I don't like my ending transparency color. It's too clear. So I'm going to go into my area, transparency, and change that from 100 to about 60%. Clicking OK and bringing it in completes my clip art. And then if I want to bring my little figure from the previous tutorial and put him in the boat, I could do that as well. The last thing I'm going to do is select everything and group them together. So now it's one single clip art.